I received the ES 100 Mark II a few days ago, but I have had the Shanling UP4 much before that, and both these devices are very similar when it comes to functionality. Both are Bluetooth DACs. This one, both of the devices have LDAC and aptX SD support. This one has higher resolution wireless audio support, but that is nothing special. Both these devices are high resolution certified, and there is nothing wrong with that. If one is not, this caught up very recently. Now, when it comes to both these devices, I really find the Shanling UP4 to be much better with build. Now, this one has both the jacks on the top of the device, but the ES 100 Mark II has both the connectors on the opposite sides, which is okay, but maybe slightly less convenient. I find the UP4 to be very well built. The build quality is excellent. Now, the problem with the UP4 is that everything has to be done with a single button, but the ES 100 Mark II has separate buttons for fast forward, backward, and volume keys. It has separate buttons for everything, and that is slightly more user friendly. That is the mic, and yeah, I find the ES 100 Mark to be slightly on the more user friendly side, and it is on the lighter side too. ES 100 Mark II is around 20 grams, and the Shanling is kind of heavier, maybe 35 40 grams. I'm not exactly sure, but yeah, maybe the heft is coming from the case too. And the case is a nice addition to the package. I really find that to be very useful because it protects it from scratches. The back is made out of glass, and yeah, the case is fairly useful when you are using it outside. This is a very good addition. Now, the ES 100 Mark II too has a clip, but it is not made as premiumly as the Shanling UP4. It is excellent with build quality. I find the ES 100 Mark II to be slightly on the lagging side because it was introduced in 2018 after all, and yeah, the micro USB is a problem. I really find the micro USB to be lagging behind the technology. It should have been a bit more up to date, but yes, it was launched in 2018, and that's that. Now, the Shanling UP4 comes with a few extras like the case, but the ES 100 Mark II doesn't have anything else but the USB cable. Both have clips, you can use them as per your usage, but I really believe that these things are meant to be used as Bluetooth DACs, not USB DACs. Now, the problem with the UP4 is that it cannot be used as a USB DAC, which is kind of a bit of letdown, but nevertheless, it doesn't matter. Both these devices are excellent when it comes to sound quality. I really find them to be very good. Now, the UP4 is a bit more detailed, it has a bit more details, it has very good technicality, but the dynamism is slightly lacking. Even though it has two 9218 chips, it is slightly lacking with dynamism. I really find it to be a bit more detailed and technically more sound, but yeah, the dynamism is not excellent with it. Now, the ES 100 Mark II has better dynamism, but it lacks a bit of grassroots level of details. Both these devices are very good nevertheless, but there are a few things to them just because of the software of these things. I'll show you guys soon. Now, the UP4 could have used a bit more dynamism. It is slightly on the darker side too. The treble is not as crisp. Now, both these devices are very good. There is no doubts about that. But they both have something in common: the apps. Both the apps are available in the Play Store. You guys can install them right away once you have bought, once you have placed orders. Now, the Shanling app is kind of basic. It doesn't have a lot of controls. It doesn't feel that evolved. Yes, you can choose codecs and sampling and stuff. The EQ, look at the EQ. It is just a basic EQ. There is nothing special in here. Just 5 band. You do not have a lot of control over things. Yes, these filters are useful, but yes, no doubts about that. This app is fairly basic. Now look at the Ear Studio app. It has much better controls. You can control the volume, both the volumes to be precise, the volume at the device. Now look at the equalizer. It has 10 bands. You can control the preamp too, which is an excellent addition to things. It has all the filters too, and you can do oversampling too, which is not present in the Shanling app. The Ear Studio app is much more evolved. Now here you can control the ambient sound, the ambient noise. You can control that. There are a lot of stuff in the ES100 Mark II, which is not present in the Shanling. Shanling app is fairly basic. The only good thing is that you can update the firmware from the app, but that cannot be done with the Ear Studio. So yeah, that's the only advantage I see of the Shanling app. There isn't anything extra in here. I really do not find that to be a deciding factor, but yeah, the ES100 has better apps, no doubt about that. ES100 is a more evolved when it comes to sound, but UP4 is the pick when it comes to sound quality. It has better sound quality, there is no doubt about that. It has better grassroots level of details, a bit more technical, but the ES100 Mark II is not lagging at all. I really like the dynamic feel. The crispiness of the treble region is much better. There isn't anything to worry about, but yes, it's more crispy. It is slightly lighter and more user-friendly. I like these buttons, but it's held back by the micro USB port, which should have been hexed. Now it's 2020. Nevertheless, if you watched till the end, thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Enjoy.